The EG4 Chargeverter is a unique little thing. It's full of technology that, in our opinion, should be built directly into all of the all-in-one inverters, and hopefully one day it will be. But for now, if you plan on incorporating a gas generator into your system, or you're just looking for a faster way to charge your batteries with AC, you're gonna need to buy one of these little guys. Welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. Today we're taking a look at the EG4 Chargeverter. This thing is jam-packed full of features that honestly most modern inverters come with, but its main job is to clean up dirty power that you get from some of these gas generators, and it works not just with EG4 batteries, you can use this with any brand 48 volt battery. So if you're a dinosaur that still uses a gas generator, or you just live in the north like we do and during the winter months you can't always rely on that sun and you need a gas generator sometimes to back up your system, this is going to be a very important component in your system. Because believe it or not, even though most generators have a specific generator power input, those inputs aren't protected from the dirty, filthy power that you get from your dinosaur gas generators. And in case you guys aren't aware, I keep on gas generators, but if you guys actually use one often and you're not already aware, they produce power in a way that's actually extremely harmful to electronics and a lot of devices that you might be trying to run off of them. But regardless, if you guys at any point want to check this thing out, we will leave links to it down below. We also have some coupon codes, you guys can save some money on purchasing this thing. But before we get into what this is, how it works, and why you would consider putting it in your setup, we're going to hit you with a super quick 60-second spec teardown in case you're not already familiar with the EG4 Chargeverter. First up, this thing obviously passes the tiny baby lift test. It weighs a total of 13 pounds. It's about the size of tiny baby's arm. This is a 48 volt battery charger rated for 100 amps and has a maximum output of 5,120 watts, which is the exact same size as most standard server rack batteries. So you can charge a full server rack battery with this guy in 1 hour flat. Inside, you basically just have an inverter that converts dirty AC power into clean DC power for your batteries. And you can actually run this off of 120 or 240 volt. The plug can actually be opened up and rewired to basically any plug that you want. With 120 volt source, you have a maximum of 3,050 watts of output, which is actually still pretty good. It has an RS-45 communication port, so it can actually communicate with your batteries and basically get a state of charge reading from them. And it also has dry contact ports, so this can actually turn your generator on and off based on that state of charge or voltage setting that you have. So it's pretty much a completely hands-off operation when it comes to this guy and using it to turn your generator on, charge your batteries, everything. It's got a built-in breaker on the front. It's got a really nice, easy to understand screen. There's really not a whole lot of options to it. It says it's rated for 10 watts of idle consumption. We haven't seen it use less than 300 though, which is interesting, even with the fans completely off. You have your two battery terminals on the one side. These are the leads that go out to your battery, and you have your AC inlet on the other side. Otherwise, it's extremely simple and there's really not a whole lot to it. And right now, this thing is $499. We have seen it on sale for about $465, I think, at best. And we actually have a $25 coupon code as well if you guys are interested to save you even a little bit of extra money. The main question that I had with this thing before we go over anything we like or all the problems with it, the things that we don't like, is what even is the point of this and why do you need one? Basically, a lot of gas generators produce what we call here in the industry, dirty power. But we don't really ever get into like pure sine waves and stuff on the channel, but once you get a generator running at full tilt, generally it's not producing a pure sine wave, and that's extremely harmful to electronics and things that need a stable output basically to run. A lot of new generators and companies have taken steps to reduce this, but older, smaller, especially cheaper gas generators are just notorious for producing dirty power. The general rule of thumb is once you pass about 60% of the generator's rated output, the pure sine wave becomes not such a pure sine wave and the power output becomes kind of hazardous to something like a computer if you're trying to run it off of that unit. So basically what that means is if you have a 6000 XP inverter and you're trying to put 6000 watts into that inverter from your generator, you're gonna want a 10,000 watt generator to safely get 6000 watts into there, which becomes extremely expensive and just unnecessary. So this is able to take a smaller inverter, use all of the power it's producing, take all the dirty power in, give it a nice little rinse off, give it a quick shower, spit it out on the other end in a way that is safe for your batteries to consume it. A really good example of this is we showed you guys Josh's cabin a couple months ago. When he first built that thing, he plugged a generator directly into it. There was no buffer in between. It was just generator powering everything in there. And when the generator was running near full tilt, you could see all the lights and everything were flickering and kind of pulsing to the beat of the generator. And that's just a perfect example of how generators are producing dirty power. Like, your lights shouldn't be flickering at all. Your power should be consistent and smooth. While it's not gonna necessarily kill a light, something like a computer or a TV or electronics that need a really stable current are really not gonna like that. And by now, a ton of you have already gone down in the comments and argued that gas generators are cheaper and better, but Google will argue that that is the exact reason that you get dirty power from them, is because they're cheaper and they use cheaper parts and they take shortcuts and produce dirty power as a result. So I'm not trying to bore you to death here. If you already have a system that incorporates a generator, or you can't afford a brand new oversized generator, EG4 has made this tiny little thing to basically incorporate into your system so that you can have a $6,000 or $3,000 or $200 generator running at full tilt and not do damage to your system. Signature Solar says the number one reason for inverter failure is actually having them hooked up to bad generators, and that actually just ends up basically frying the entire inverter because it was getting dirty power and it's not built to handle that. You've already spent a ton of money on inverters and batteries and probably even a generator, even if it was a shitty one. This is a relatively cheap cost to pay for insurance of the longevity of your system and the batteries and the inverter and everything you've already kind of paid for. You can also just plug this directly into an AC outlet. You could plug it into a regular wall outlet and you could use it to just take that power and charge your batteries faster than you normally would be able to without it. And this puts out 5,000 watts of power to your batteries. So there's a lot of circumstances where your inverter might not even put out 5,000 watts to your batteries. You can actually use this to charge faster than your small inverter that you have in your cabin or something. The first thing that I actually really like about this is that it saves someone who already has a generator that they spent their hard-earned money on, and they maybe can't afford to get a new one or one that's way oversized just for their system. You can just buy this and use it to maximize the output of your generator while keeping the longevity of all your other products, and it works. I just really like that. I also like that this has the dry connections and automation built right into it. So basically, you could set this to turn your generator on when your battery gets below 50% and turn your generator off when your battery gets to 90%. So say you live in an area or it's the middle of winter or whatever, and you're not sure if the sun's gonna come out today, you can have this automatically do the work, kick on your generator, charge up your system. You don't even have to be around while this happens. And that is just honestly a really cool feature. Like, your inverter and stuff can do that, but the fact that they built it directly into this is huge. And like I said earlier, if you don't have it connected with a communication cable, it uses the voltage to trigger the on and off settings. It doesn't use the state of charge. If your inverter doesn't allow pass through, you can charge your batteries with this while your inverter is taking power from your batteries to run a load. So that's a pretty cool cheat. If you have a smaller system, something that doesn't allow pass through, you can use this as a bypass mode. Ford Lightning has the bed plug thing in the back. You could plug this into that and use it to convert power and send it into your battery bank if you needed to. You can basically wire this up to anything that you want, which is huge. It's also pretty cool in the fact that you can do a lot of random things with this. So if you have like a server rack cabinet and your inverter can only put out so much power to those batteries, you could disconnect the bottom three batteries, for example, and use this to charge them. You could use this to charge your golf cart at probably a much faster rate than you're already charging your golf cart. Anywhere that you have a battery that you need to charge that's 48 volts, if you're already charging your system with solar and you want to add more juice to it, you could even stack this and just jam power into your batteries. Like always though, there's a few things that we don't love about this thing. And the first one is you can't direct power to a battery if that battery is running a load that exceeds what this is putting into it. Basically, if you're trying to charge at 5,000 watts and you're running a 6,000 watt load, it's not gonna like that, it's not gonna work. So you basically have to be using less than 5,000 watts from the battery that you're charging for this thing to work, which is, I mean, I get why, like it makes perfect sense, but it is just a little frustrating. That's why earlier I suggested you like disconnect a couple batteries in the server rack and charge them individually or something like that. I also don't love the operating temperature is only rated for 14 degrees Fahrenheit, and I get electronics can only do so much, but you know, the places, if you think about it, that might need this to use a gas generator, generally are gonna be using that gas generator because they're far from the equator, they can't necessarily rely on the sun in the winter, and it's cold because it's winter. So where we live, for example, when I would need to use this thing and have a gas generator running to back up my system is when it's the coldest it's gonna get all year, and it generally is below 14 degrees Fahrenheit during those times. So if you're in the middle of Snowmageddon and you have this in a garage that's not heated, you might run into problems. And the last thing is, why EG4? Realistically, we're early on in the days of solar still. Can we get this built into an inverter? Because why do I gotta buy a separate piece? My inverter has a generator input, and I understand that this was meant to solve a problem for people that already had inverters and already had generators, and they're like, oh, we're blowing the inverters up. How do we stop this from happening? We make this, we won't blow up any more inverters. Nice. In the future though, this is not a very big package. Let's put this inside of the inverters that we're already paying money for. Then we don't have to have the extra piece in our system. We're paying for an all-in-one inverter, and I'm kind of to the belief right now that it's not truly all-in-one because this is not in there. So it'd be really cool to see this built into inverters in the future. So look, I'm gonna use the absolute crap out of this thing because we have a ton of batteries here at the lab, and I'm just gonna use this to fast charge all of them all the time. I'm not even gonna use it with a gas generator, but for those of you that already have an existing setup, this might come at a much cheaper cost than upgrading other components of your setup, and it might save you a lot of headache and money down the road. So I do think that for people that already have a system on the go or are just in the middle of building one right now, when this isn't available inside of inverters already, this is kind of a crucial component. And while no one likes spending money on something that they think they already have, you might regret not having this down the road. So that is it. That is all we got for you guys today. Thank you guys so much for watching. We will catch you next time. Peace out and stay charged.